We feel like we have a very strong case, and going forward, we have attorneys that are helping us challenge and appeal to the RNC, where this will end up in the hands of the contest committee to have a determination on which delegation gets seated.
Hey, Jake, have you read the letter they just sent to Daily Call?
Yes. What, the attorney letter?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Our attorney letter or reply from their attorney?
I've read the both. I don't know what,
which one is the response.
There has been a, there has been a response, like we did.
I've got the response on the phone. He does.
I got it.
We have a copy.
Posted today. It's been emailed. Awesome.
Other response?
Maybe we should read it.
Do you want me to read it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That'd be great. That's.
This is their response.
Okay, this is the response from.
So we sent them.
Let's wait. Let's focus on who needs to read the response from their attorneys.
This is the release for.
Okay, so there was Lucas and among other parliamentarians and lawyers, they compiled a letter and sent it to Matt Pinnell. He got it about 2 or 3 days ago, said he would read it last night. Probably read it a long before that, but they responded to that letter. That the one we sent was 6 pages, this is 1 page, and this is our release. I am in receipt of your letter today, dated May 22nd, 2012. The Oklahoma Republican Party held its state convention on May 11th, 2012. The meeting began at 9 a.m. Central Time and concluded promptly, as announced throughout the meeting at 5 p.m. upon a vote of the convention to adjourn. During the proceeding, the delegates of the convention voted to approve the convention rules without amendment. Further, the convention body elected with quorum present a slate of 25 delegates and 25 alternates to represent it in Tampa at the 2012 Republican National Convention. It appears we agree that only, quote, lawfully elected delegates and alternates, end quote, should be sent to the Republican National Convention. It also appears we disagree that any delegates elected outside were, quote, lawfully elected. The Oklahoma Republican Party recognizes that the Republican National Committee outlines procedures that may be followed for challenges and that your clients may be entitled to exercise the privileges offered through these procedures. Despite the privileges outlined in the RNC rules, however, the Oklahoma Republican Party is compelled by its rules to prepare its properly selected and approved delegation for the Republican National Convention. Any challenge your clients bring forward, which is their privilege under the rules, will not prevent the Oklahoma Republican Party from moving forward with the process, with the processing of its delegates. Should you feel it necessary to discuss this matter further, please feel free to contact me. Everybody write this down. 202-486-7211 or by
could
email.
You repeat that?
It's live stream.
Could you repeat that?
Sure. 202-486-7212 or 7211, sorry.
And who is that?
That is AJ Ferrara. Well, it's in his email. I guess it's
what was that phone number and email again?
One more time.
The name and the phone number and the email again?
Yeah.
Yes, you should. And look at the laptop so they can hear you.
I got you. AJ at FERATEPLLC.com. Respectfully, Anthony AJ Friday.
Is that the name of the attorney?
That is.
And then where is he located?
Washington.
In Washington, D.C.?
202, that's D.C.
Okay.
Yeah. Just note that there was no citation that there were in our 6-page document, and he says any challenge your clients bring forward, which is their privilege under the rules, will not prevent the Oklahoma Republican Party from moving forward. We can absolutely do that.
He's blowing smoke.
If we proved and the RNC accepts or the credentials committee accepts that they were not lawfully elected, there's no way they'll be seated, and it will absolutely annul any processing of delegates in there.